Okay, this is the start of making my petticoat for the Cinderella dress, and I'm using a full circle skirt pattern, which I'm cutting in two halves. So here in front of me, I just have one half. Okay, the fabric I'm using is like a medium weight white crepe, which I found at a fabric store about 15 miles away or so. So I decided to go with that so that it flows out quite nicely, because I want a dress that's going to go like right out. And I thought it'd be nice if the petticoat went out with the dress at the same time. So, okay, so here I have my two half circles that have been cut on the fold. So when I open it out, here we go, I've got one big half circle here. Now I'm going to be using this hoop that I got quite a few years ago off eBay. It's one of the better quality cotton ones that I used for my Disney Giselle dress. And obviously before cutting your half circle skirt, you want to make sure you get the right length down to the bottom. And then I shall be adding some lace onto the bottom of my petticoat later on.
Okay, having sewn up the side seams, we now fold the whole skirt. So we've just got a quarter section here. And then we've made an interfacing. Lay 7 to 8 centimetres wide and about 18 centimetres long. Neatened it all the way around, and where you have your back seam on your skirt, I'm just going to do a line with my tailor's chalk to about an inch before it reaches the bottom of the facing. That's just so that I've got a straight line here to work from. Right, we've opened up the skirt now so that we can see what we're doing, and this is the chalk mark that we made. Now what I'm going to do is lay on the interfacing on the right side of the skirt, and you can just about see the tailor's chalk through this interfacing, so I'm going to make sure that's in the middle. Pin that down. Okay, now what I'm going to do is get my tailor's chalk and, picking up the line underneath, I'm going to transfer that onto the facing on the top. So, the next step is that you're going to sew a sewing line down one side of your mark. Then when you get to the bottom, you're going to come across 90 degrees with a couple of stitches and then come up the other side of your mark. Okay, having sewn our lines, we're now going to cut down in between sewing, right down to the bottom. Now that we've made that cut, what we need to do now is go to the bottom of the facing and just cut the facing only up to as far as you're sewing, right in the middle. And what we will do next is fold the whole facing in all the way around, and then that will be pinned and have a sewing line put in to finish.
I'm going to use a silver ribbon to make the tie for my petticoat. At the moment I'm just pinning it on edge to edge, like so.
What we've just done with the petticoat is we've just sewn on some 1.5 inch ribbon onto the top of the petticoat. And then what we will do now is just run a sewing stitch across there to hold the seam down.
Okay, I've now sewn along the edge here, as you can just see, pulling this as tight as possible as I go. And that finishes that top bit basically. Now on to the bottom, in which I've already put this on and we've got the length already. We've just overlocked the edge, but if you haven't got an overlocker, just turn it up, hem it up as normal. And I've put some marks on, or rather I should say Mum put some marks on while I was standing on a chair, and I'm going to be attaching some lace. I bought this really nice glittery and metallic-y looking wide lace from Abercan Fabrics in North Wales. Bought about 10 metres, and I just thought it looked kind of pretty, so if my petticoat should show through at the bottom when I lift the dress up, then I've got a nice glittery trim on the bottom. I thought it looked really special, so I bought it. It's just under 3 inches wide. So a reasonably good width. And literally I'm going to start at the back seam, and obviously you need to turn your lace inwards because you don't want to just start sewing on the edge, because it'll look tatty and it might start fraying over time just a little bit, and you don't really want that. So here I have the back opening of the skirt, and I've done this already, but I put a pin there to mark where the back of the skirt is at the bottom, so I know where to start by lace. First of all, start off by making sure you have a straight edge on your lace. Okay, we're just turning it inwards by about 2 centimetres and securing it in place with a pin. So now you have a nice neat edge to start with. Now these are pencil marks I put on earlier, about 1 inch from the bottom, and they're just there to give me a guide where to attach the lace to as I go along. So in the meantime, I shall be back once I've pinned all this lace in place. This is the finished Cinderella petticoat. Overall, I used about 7 to 8 metres of lace in the end out of the 10 metres I bought. The back. There we go, that completes the petticoat. For my main outer skirt, I've decided on 3 layers. For the under layer, I'm using this lightweight pale blue polyester voile fabric. It's extremely cheap to buy. There's roughly about 4 metres in it, and I use the same pattern as I used to make the petticoat, which is basically a full circle skirt made in two halves again. We've prepared a slit in the back already for an opening, which I've just temporarily pinned there for now, because eventually I'll be joining all three skirts to a waistband. Okay, exciting news, I've just had my fabric through. This is going to be the third layer of my skirt, and I've bought roughly 8 meters, and I've just rolled it out here because I was just checking that they have sent me 8 meters, which they have, so all good. It is white silk satin charmeuse that I bought off eBay that came from China, which I made an offer on it for him, and he accepted, so all good again. Now, I couldn't find the colour I wanted in the blue, so I'm going to dye this fabric using Dylon China Blue, which is quite a nice blue. And this is machine dye. Because I got dye so much, I thought it'd be easier to do it in the machine, as in washing machine. This was a test piece I did earlier, and it's come out quite nice. I don't want it as strong a blue as what Disney have done recently, and they've made Cinderella like a more of a darker sky blue. I'm trying to stay with the theme of the original movie, which was more of sort of pale blues and silvery pale blues, so I'm going to go for that. Wish me luck. Okay, I've now dyed my fabric in a washing machine. I've given it a bit of an iron, and we're just in the process of making this skirt. Now, it wasn't as wide as the other fabrics, so we've got to do it in sections. So basically, my quarter of a full skirt panel that I have here has been, we've had to fold it in because obviously it's not wide enough. So we're going to probably make it up in, we think, about 6 sections. Unfortunately, this fabric can't be bought in wider widths after asking around, so we have to make do. This is the first piece already cut out, so I have to cut another 5 of these, so I'll have 6 altogether. I've now sewn up my 6 sections of satin altogether, and as you can see, it makes one huge skirt. The next thing I have to do is sort out my waist and where the back opening is going to be.
Okay, all the skirts have been cut, and we're just trying them on for now. I shan't be bothering with the hem for a time, not until everything's on the waistband. And this is showing all 3 pieces of the skirt. We have the top layer, second layer, and the inside layer. At the moment they're all separate, and they've just got a little slit down the side, and what will happen with that is that we'll put an interfacing onto it and neaten it up, and then all 3 of these skirts will be put onto a waistband. We need to cut an interfacing for the skirts, and this one is approximately 20 centimetres long by about 8 centimetres wide. That's going to be for our neatening interfacing. And then for the skirt, this is doubled over, and I'm just going to have this so that it overlaps at the back, and it needs to be as long as your waist plus 2 centimetres longer each side. Then you need to cut a piece of petersham or webbing, slightly shorter, and the next thing we're going to do is just sew up the ends of the waistband. Next stage is to get all 3 skirts in the right order, and then just tack them all together around the top. Pin all the layers together down the slit at the back, which is approximately 7 inches long, and then do the same with your interfacing. Then we're going to place that on there, and then we're going to sew down the V and then up the other side, sewing all the pieces together. When you've sewn the interfacing on, turn it to the inside of the slit and then re-sew along the edges on both sides. Okay, turn the band the right way out, and then starting right at the end, you're going to pin and tack your skirt onto your waistband all the way across.
Now I run the sewing line on my band and attached it to the skirts.
Okay, we're now going to do the waistband. First of all, turn over a small amount onto the stiffener that you're going to use, and turn that again against the skirt and the sewing line, and then pin that in place. Do that all the way along the waistband, and then after that we'll be hand sewing it. For the back closing, we've decided to put hooks and eyes onto ours, but it's entirely up to you what sort of fastening you put on, whether you want hooks and eyes or snap fasteners or a piece of velcro, it's up to you.
I've now hemmed up all three layers of my skirt. At the moment I've just left the bottom of the outer skirt overlocked. I've been debating whether I should do a turnover on it or not, but I can't decide, so I'm going to decide later. Anyway, I want a nice pattern on the outside of my skirt because my bodice is going to be this lovely rose floor brocade fabric. So I've bought a nice little rose stamp and some ink, which is made by VersaCraft, was it? Oh, it was VersaCraft Sky Mist. Oh, there we go, I found it now. Sorry. VersaCraft stamp. And this was one I bought just to test it, so I've actually got some bigger ink pads over here. So they come in different sizes. And I've decided to stamp this pattern onto my organza. And I didn't want a pattern that stood out too much or not enough, and I found that this suited this colour. So now I'm going to go ahead and stamp pattern onto nearly 5 to 6 metres of fabric. So wish me luck and I'll see you later. Okay, I've now finished stamping the organza fabric. And I've also bought some Swarovski crystals in colour light sapphire, size roughly 3 millimetres. And I've also bought these blue motifs off eBay. They came all the way from Australia, they're quite nice. So I've just added those every few inches along the bottom of the skirt. Those turned out quite nice. There's a nice frothy feel to it anyway. And I have decided to keep the bottom of the skirt with this lovely frilly edge because I think it kind of looks pretty. So anyway, you will see it later on in all its glory in a future video.